Hi everyone, this is Dr. Manu Krishnan K, and in today's session, we will be discussing about the palmar aponeurosis. So let's discuss the term first. What do you mean by an aponeurosis? An aponeurosis is nothing but a flattened extension of the muscular tendons. So here also you can just make out in this simple diagram here, you can see an extension which is flattened and that is arising from the palmar's longest tendon. And that is termed as the palmar aponeurosis. So it lies within the hand or palm and it is arising as the continuation of the palmar's longest tendon. So let's see about it in detail. So it is the central part of the deep fascia of the palm which covers the following structures that are the superficial palmar arch, long flexor tendons, terminal part of the median nerve and its branches, then the superficial branch of the ulnar nerve. So these are the structures which are covered by this deep fascia, or like a modified deep fascia, which is present within the central part of the palm. And it is nothing but the morphologically degenerated tendon of the palmaris longus muscle. So that gives the introduction for the palmar aponeurosis. And let's discuss the structure of palmar aponeurosis. As you can see here in the diagram, it is triangular in shape. It is a flattened triangular shape deep fascia modification, and being a triangle, it has got an apex here which is present proximally, and we have a base here which is placed distally. So let's discuss what is the apex. So the apex is the proximal part of the palmar aponeurosis and it blends with the flexor retinaculum. So the green color which I have represented here is the flexor retinaculum. And we already know that the palmaris longus tendon will be passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. So the apex of the palmar aponeurosis is blended with the distal part of the flexor retinaculum. And then it is continuous with the palmaris longus tendon. And what about the base? The base is directed distally and it divides into four slips. So can you see, if you just look closer, you can see that it is divided into four slips at the end. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have to count it from the thumb side. So we have to count it from the lateral aspect. That is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there are four slips arising opposite to the heads of the metacarpals of the medial four digits. So these are the medial four digits. So the metacarpal bone will be located here in the palmar region, right? So it has got, here is the lower end, then we have the head portion here. So the head of the metacarpals of the medial four digits at that particular level, this palmar aponeurosis will divide into four different slips. And in between these slips, you can see some spaces. Here you can see some semicircular spaces, right? And through that spaces only, the vessels and nerves will be passing into the fingers. Here you can see there is red color marking, that is nothing but the vessels which are supplying the fingers. So we will be seeing which are those branches passing through that gap. That we'll be studying later when we study the structures which are lying deep to the palmar aponeurosis. So since we see the first structure, that is the palmar aponeurosis, then we'll remove the palmar aponeurosis and we'll see structures beneath it. Then the base, these each slips will again divide into two parts. There is a deep part and a superficial part, and they are continuous with the fibrous flexor sheaths. So that is a question, what is fibrous flexor sheath? They are nothing but the sheaths covering the digits. So that we'll be studying later. So you should know that this palmar aponeurosis will eventually at the base region, it divides into four slips. And each of these slips will divide into deep and superficial ones, and that will be continuous with that of the fibrous flexor sheaths of the fingers. So this is the structure of the palmar aponeurosis. And as I have told you previously, the digital vessels, nerves and the tendons of the lumbricals emerge through the intervals between the slips. We have seen the intervals between the slips, right? So through that, these particular structures will be passing. And from the lateral and medial margins of the palmar aponeurosis, there are two septum arising, and they are namely the lateral palmar septum and the medial palmar septum. So here you can see there will be one septum which is arising from the medial margin and one from the lateral margin, and they will go directly backwards to the dorsum of the palm, like it will be directed backwards, and that will divide the particular palm into different compartments. So here will be one septum which will form a compartment here, and there will be the lateral septum here which will be forming another compartment here. So similarly, like we will be studying the spaces of the palm later, and that is a different topic. So at least you should know the septa are formed from the medial and lateral margins of the palmar aponeurosis. So these septa passes backwards and divides the palm into compartments. So that is what we have to remember. Then what are the functions of this palmar aponeurosis? It fixes the skin of the palm and thus improves the gripping capability of the hand. And it also protects the underlying tendons, vessels and nerves. We have seen many vessels and nerves passing between that interval and all, right? So there will be some major vessels which are located beneath the palmar aponeurosis. So our primary defense mechanism is by the hand. When you are falling down, you will try to stretch your hand and just break the fall, right? And if someone is attacking you, the palm will be the first part of defense. So there are some important structures lying within the palm which needs to be protected. So palmar aponeurosis is something that protects this particular structures lying beneath it. And what is the clinical anatomy of palmar aponeurosis? So the first thing you have to remember is Dupuytren's contracture, and it is nothing but an inflammation involving the ulnar side or medial side of the palmar aponeurosis. So this is little finger side is the medial side. So these ulnar side of the palmar aponeurosis will get inflamed, and that will become thickened and very contracted. So this contraction and the thickening of the ulnar side of this particular palmar aponeurosis causes the flexion of the proximal phalanx as well as the middle phalanx of the fingers. So particularly the ring finger is most affected, and sometimes the little finger also. So these two fingers will be involved in the Dupuytren's contracture, and the contraction and thickening of the ulnar side of palmar aponeurosis will cause the flexion of the proximal phalanx and middle phalanx of the ring finger and little finger, and it cannot be straightened because it's a permanent contracture. And while the terminal phalanx of this particular two fingers will be not affected because only the extension of this flexor, like the tendons, will be coming till the middle phalanx. So these two will be affected and the other fingers won't be affected at all. So this is called as the Dupuytren's contracture. So you have to refer in the Google, like just search for Dupuytren's contracture, where you can find the clear images of Dupuytren's contracture and it along with its clinical presentation. So you have to refer the picture from the Google and see the description which I have given here and compare it. Thank you.